In this Ivanti video, we're going to look at some results in an effective license position that can seem a little counterintuitive at first. The results we're going to look at in this video I call Schrödinger's licenses because, like the famed cat in the thought experiment that was simultaneously alive and dead until a waveform collapsed, these are licenses that you have both a surplus and a deficit of. How can that be? Oh well. Let me show you two possible ways. In my data summary, you can see that for Microsoft Project 2019, I have a shortfall of 1 and a surplus of 1. And for Microsoft SQL Server 2016 Enterprise, using a per-core metric, I have a shortfall of 16 and a surplus of 8. Both of these are correct, but seem a little strange at first, and are for different reasons. Let's consider the position for Project first. The default view for the data summary shows the effective license position for your estate. For Project, I have both a shortfall and a surplus of 1. Why can't I use the surplus to cover my shortfall? If we click the row for Project, avoiding any of the hyperlinks, the product information dialog appears. And now we can see why we have both a surplus and a deficit for Microsoft Project. For the UK business unit, we have a liability of 1 and no licenses, giving a balance of negative 1. Whereas for the US business unit, we have a liability of 1 and 2 licenses, giving a balance of plus 1. This is how I have both a surplus and a deficit. I have 2 licenses for the US, but only 1 installation there, and 1 installation in the UK, but no licenses there. If I uninstalled Project from the PC in the UK, and then installed it on a PC in the US, all would be well. Now let's look at the SQL Server issue. If I click the row for that entry as before, I can see that the problem isn't caused by business units. I have a liability of 32 in the UK, but I have only 24 licenses. However, if my arithmetic is correct, 32 take away 24 is 8. So why do I have a deficit of 16? I can see the answer to this question using the Software by Install tab, which shows each instance of installed software and its liabilities. Let's filter the installed software column to show only SQL Server. We can see that this is installed on 2 servers, and that both servers have a liability of 16. This answers our question, because you can't partially license a server for SQL Server. You either cover the entire liability or none of it. We have 2 servers, both needing 16 licenses. The first server takes 16 licenses, leaving us with 8 licenses, which isn't enough to cover the other server. So those 8 licenses aren't used. They are our surplus. And the second server is unlicensed. Those 16 licenses required for the server are our deficit. In good news, adding a further 8 licenses will give us enough licenses to cover this deficit because we can add those to our surplus of 8. Before we finish, let me reassure you that no cats nor licenses were harmed in the making of this video. I hope you enjoyed it and found it useful. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to see more videos about all of Ivanti's products.